The film centers on the friendship between Bharata, the prince of Kansar, and Deva, a tribesman played by Prithviraj and Prabhas respectively, and is set in the dystopian city-state of Kansar. Bharata enlists Deva's assistance to take Kansar's throne from his father's ministers and relatives as they plot an uprising. Salaar recently started streaming on Netflix, and I was super excited to watch it. I initially wanted to watch it in theaters, but stuff was happening in life, so I couldn't. After watching the whole movie, there were some aspects in it that disappointed me more than I thought it did, resulting in this not achieving the legendary status I hold Prashant Neel's previous three films. This is, as of this recording, his weakest film, but there were some aspects that I did like, so let's talk about that first. I liked Prabhas as Devarata Raisar, Deva alias Salaar, and Videsh Anand as young Deva. He looks so cool on screen and his action scenes are so stylish. He becomes a total badass once he starts getting serious. Even Videsh did his job well. His performance at his character introduction scene, where he had to make a Hulk-like wrestler fall to the ground, was so well done. I also liked the presence of Jagapati Babu as Rajamannar. He had a very intimidating presence to him and was very convincing as the current king of Kansar. He's not in the movie for a while. He's there in the beginning few scenes and then he doesn't show up till the near end of the voting scene. Whenever he was on screen, his look, presence, and performance was captivating. For me, Prithviraj Sukumaran as Varadaraja Mannar or Bharata was okay in the film. He has some good action scenes and his bond with Salaar is fine, but aside from his style, he wasn't as memorable as Salaar. I was disappointed when the movie failed to explore their friendship in depth as adults. When they unite after years of being apart, they just hug for a second and start fighting the bad guys. I wanted for the film to explore these characters in depth because I didn't feel for anybody in this movie. Now for the stuff I disliked. I did not care for the mother-son bond between Salaar and his mother played by Aishwari Rao. A shame since the mother-son bond between the main character and his mother were one of the more endearing aspects of his previous films. Here, not only is Aishwari Rao's character the same as Agastya's mother in the 2014 movie Ugram, but Aishwari Rao failed to provide the emotional connection that was flawlessly imparted by Padmaja Rao in Ugram. Even Shruti Hassan's portrayal of Adhya Krishnakant seems to be a watered-down version of Haripriya's Nitya in Ugram. The main difference is that while Haripriya's Nitya was crucial to the plot, Shruti Hassan's character feels like a waste of time in a film that is already 2 hours and 55 minutes long. I'm not sure how significant she will be in part 2, but in this movie, her presence distracted me from the Kansar's secret society, which is the main focus of the narrative. Ultimately, she serves as our entry point into the world of Kansar, similarly to how Haripriya does into the region of Mukur. But I thought that the approach they chose to do so was ineffective and wasteful. When we go away from her story, the film entirely abandons her and she is just told the story, which becomes tiresome. I did not like how similar this movie was to Ugram, both in terms of story and characters, to the point where you can say this is just another variation of the 2014 film. There are so many scenes that are done so much better in Ugram. The main character's vow of non-violence because his mother made him do so, the mother telling her son to break the vow to save the female lead as the female lead is being taken away by gangsters, The main character returning to the place he was exiled from. The main character speaking to the mother of the girl about to be raped before killing the rapist. The main character in a strong friendship but does something that causes a rift in the friendship, etc., etc. In a nutshell, a huge majority of Salaar is just Ugram in a KGF-like color palette. What I absolutely hated is how this movie is nothing but a build-up to part 2 without a satisfying payoff. What I mean by this is, this movie keeps on giving build-up after build-up, and when we eventually reach the climax, it ends. Some might say to wait for part 2 for the payoff, but that's exactly the issue here. The film is entirely dependent on part 2 to complete it, whereas if you look at its previous film, KGF Chapter 1 had a beginning, middle, and an end with the remaining few minutes to be the build-up for Chapter 2. The same can be said for KGF Chapter 2 as well. If the story has to be divided into several parts, then each part needs to be able to stand on their own. And analyzing this movie on its own, it is structurally weak. Despite all of my issues with this film, I would watch part 2 just to see how Prashant Neel intends to continue the story. However, Salaar Part 1 Ceasefire is a fun movie, but is definitely Prashant Neel's weakest installment in this filmography. The movie is visually stunning, but you do not connect with the characters. I don't know if these characters would even be remembered in the same way as Agastya in Ugram or Rajakrishnappa Bairya or, you know, Rocky in KGF films, as they were neither engaging nor appealing. If you have watched Ugram and or are not a fan of Prabhas and or Prithviraj Sukumaran, then this movie will be a waste of time for you and you can skip this franchise. Otherwise, this will be a fun, massive, and mostly intense blockbuster for you. That's my opinion on Salaar Part 1 Ceasefire. Do you agree with my thoughts? What are your thoughts of the film? Let me know in the comments. Please do drop a like and subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you in the next video. What did happen to the last 10? I ran away with my life, fast forward, never turn back again. It's kind of funny that the more we pass time.